I'm going to show you how to optimize your WordPress site with free plugins and settings from hosting that are completely free. So let's go jump over to my desktop. The idea is to show you how to optimize your WordPress site with free plugins and settings on hosting that are not going to cost you a thing. So we're going to go into our Hostinger dashboard, which is my sponsor for this video. And before we jump into the actual settings, let me show you a deal that they have. So on their main page, you can grab a shared hosting, which is pretty inexpensive. We'll go into web hosting and you can select from one of the three plans that they have available. I would recommend the premium web hosting or the business web hosting. Let me show you what price you can get with the discount coupon code that I can provide you. So if we select this one, we add it to cart, and we're gonna select from one of the time frames from the plan that we selected. So you can grab from 1 to 48 months. I recommend that you grab the 48 months because you lock in the price and the renewal price is cheaper also. So it's recommend that you grab this one. Plus, there's an extra discount coupon code, like I mentioned, and we're gonna select have a coupon code, and we're gonna type in or copy and paste the coupon code from the description that I'm leaving here on the bottom, and we're gonna apply it, and we're gonna get an extra discount. So now it's $129.17 for the 48 months. That's really inexpensive. Okay, so what settings are we gonna do on our hosting plan? So from here on this panel, I recommend that you tweak a few settings to get better performance and optimize your WordPress site. First, I would go into the advanced settings and I'm gonna customize the PHP configuration. If you're using another hosting plan, just go into the PHP settings. Now, I would recommend that you select the highest PHP version, which is gonna be the most optimized one for our WordPress site. Be aware that just make sure that you have everything up to date, plugins and themes, and that they are compatible with the latest version of PHP. There we go, this one has been updated. Another setting that I would set here is the cache manager, which is available with the Hostinger plan. And I'm gonna enable this. Here we go. And I can select a specific page to purge if I like. But in this case, it's gonna cache this site. What is that? Well, when someone visits your site constantly, it's gonna have a cache file that it's gonna serve really quickly because it's already gonna serve it because it has it available. And that's what cache does. So that's really interesting, right? Now, in terms of the free plugins that I want to show you, well, they're gonna be over here. Plugins, we are gonna add new, and we're gonna search for the first plugin that I want to show you. We're gonna need a plugin that can actually compress images. So I would recommend, and I use this one when I'm gonna use a free one, is Smush. I'm gonna install this, and what it does, it's gonna optimize images so they don't lose quality, but they are more light. That means that they're gonna load faster on your site. So that means it's gonna be optimized. And this is completely free. Now I'm gonna go into settings. I can begin the setup, but I'll skip this for now. It's gonna check the images that we have on this page. This is a demo site that I'm using, so no images here. But the settings, we're gonna image sizes all, automatic compress. So that means that when you're working on your site and you upload our new images, it's gonna automatically compress it, okay? We can super smush, but that would be on the premium plan. The metadata, we can strip that image data so it's a bit lighter. The image resizing, we can resize the original image, and we can also compress the original image, and we can also decide to back up original images. If we do care about our images and you want to keep a backup of the original one without being compressed, enable this, okay? And then we can start the bulk. Once we save it, it's going to optimize all the images, and it's going to compress them 30-70%. It's going to depend how big that image is and how much it compresses it without losing quality. Okay, now there's more settings to this. For example, you can use a lazy load. We can enable that and we can go ahead and activate it. There's the CDN settings, local web P, and that's going to be on the pro version. So, but what we want is the compression of the images, and we're going to get that with the free plugin. Another plugin that I recommend is a cache plugin. So let's go ahead and search for it. On the cache plugin, again, there's several of these that are free and they are really great to use. For example, there's Lightspeed Cache, there's W3 Total Cache, WP Super Cache. Any of these five are a really great option. I like to use W3 Total Cache because it does a great job. And again, we're gonna use the free version and it's gonna be totally workable. Now, what cache plugins do, like I mentioned before, as the hosting does, is cache the files so they load them quickly. But aside from that, they have other settings that are really great. So let me show you. Here on performance, there's several settings. We can do a minify. That means that it's going to minify our settings from the HTML on the site for the JS files and the CSS. So I'll go next. We'll test the page cache. Here we go. And we're gonna do a basic or enhanced if recommended. And you can see it's a 80% minification, okay? We can test the database cache also. Here we go, here's our options. We're gonna keep that one. So we'll do next, test object cache. Again, we're gonna keep none for that because we're not gonna get an improvement. Now this is a demo site, but if we have a huge site that's more complex, it's gonna be way better, all right? Test the browse cache, we can enable that. Let's go next. We're gonna enable lazy load on images. And here we go, let's go back into the dashboard. Now it's been optimized with the cache settings. And again, there's several of these cache settings, for example, that are really interesting, like the ones in the page cache. We're gonna enable or disable these. Now, something that you have to be aware when you're using a cache plugin is that you have to enable, save, and go test it because there's a lot of changes that can be drastic and it can break the site. So if that happens, if it breaks, is it kind of like everything's all over the place, we'll go come back, disable that one, and try other settings that will improve your website optimization with this one. These are the two plugins that I recommend that you have. These are essential for any WordPress site. Something that will compress and optimize the images and something that will cache the files, all right? And basically, all of these are free. So there you go. That is how you're gonna optimize a WordPress site really easily and for free. Well, that's a wrap.